The work of the Biden administration in trade is very much predicated on ensuring that small farmers are successful, that we are able to ensure that sustainability is part of the discussions on trade. So the work of IEECA at building coalitions across the Americas, of putting a focus on productivity for farmers, making sure that small landholders are successful, and to make sure that stewardship and sustainability are part of the broad discussions on international cooperation, is very much a perfect fit of what we're trying to get done on trade right now. So it's a pleasure for me to visit with the team here, to understand all the work that's being done, the very important work, and to be in a position to partner and to help amplify all of the work that IEECA does. Yeah, so the U.S. Trade Representative's Office works very collaboratively with countries throughout the Americas. I'm making several visits to Central America and to South America to build relations, to show how the benefits of trade from our agreements and our work together benefit all countries together. We have very robust trade. For example, Costa Rica sends nearly $2 billion of agricultural commodities to the United States every year. That number is up over $1 billion more than it was the passage of the CAFTA trade agreement. So this is a chance for us to talk collaboratively about how we all benefit from trade, how we can make sure even more small farmers benefit from trade, how we can increase the number of commodities that flow in both directions, and ultimately to help build rural economies, to help make sure that small towns and villages and that farmers of all sizes are seeing the economic benefits from agricultural trade. Yeah, so right now, if we look across the globe, some of the challenges that climate change has presented, whether it be increased pest pressures, increased pressure on drought to crops, in some cases excess water, heat stress on plants, all of those factors precipitated by climate impact the ability for a farmer to be productive. And we are now seeing, for example, low water levels in the Panama Canal, that we have restrictions on vessel traffic, but we also have productivity challenges too. So our work, the United States government work on trade agreements, is to make sure that sustainability has a place and a role in trade discussions, that we are promoting local flexibility for conservation practices, and that ultimately we're doing things that are going to incentivize a farmer to adopt conservation practices. So the work that IEECA is doing throughout the Americas of bringing together technology transfer, productive dialogues on policy, all of that really fits in perfectly with having a constructive discussion about trade and sustainability. And quite honestly, it puts the Americas in a position to approach the globe with one voice and to be agents of change throughout the globe for positive trade and for sustainability.